Welcome once again. In our previous classes, we saw what is continuous beams, what is how to draw the bending moments of a continuous beam, what is Clapeyron's theorem of three moments, and we saw two problems when the end supports are simple supports. The previous problems, what we have solved is continuous beams with end supports are also simple supports. Okay. So we saw two problems, one two span simply supported continuous beam and another one is a three span simple supported continuous beam. Now we will go on for type 2 problems, that is continuous beams with fixed end supports. So if the end supports are fixed, that means we will have as many intermediate supports and we will have end supports. Our end supports will be fixed supports. So such beams, if the end supports are fixed, okay, so intermediate supports may be simple supports and the end supports are fixed. So if the beam is fixed at end supports, then an imaginary span, that is a zero span, is to be taken to the next of a fixed support. So we will take this support as A, this support as B. If this is the case, see, if A is a fixed support, to the left of A, next to A, we will have a zero span. Okay, so this zero span can be taken as A dash. So A dash A will be a zero span, and here also, see, if B is a simple support, there is no need of an imaginary span next to B. But if B is a fixed support, we need to assume another imaginary span B B dash. Okay, that means, see, if our in symbol, if the end supports are fixed supports, we have to consider an imaginary zero span next to the supports. That is, if it is a left support, to the left of the support. If the fixed end is right end, then right of the support. So after that, we have to apply Clapeyron's theorem as usual. See, now this is A, B, this is a C, D, E. How many unknowns are there? Moment at A is unknown, moment at C is unknown, moment at D is unknown, moment at E is unknown, and moment at B is unknown. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So totally 5 unknowns. So if we have 5 unknowns, we require 5 equations. That is 5 three-moment equations to solve the 5 unknowns. That means, first we will take the span A dash A, first set of span is A dash A and AC. This will be our first set of span. So we will get one equation. Second set of span is AC CD. So we will have second equation. Third is CD DE. We will get third equation. Then DE EB, we will get fourth equation, and EB BB dash, we will get the fifth equation. So we will have 5 three-moment equation. So by solving these 5 equations, we will get the 5 unknowns. Okay, this is the concept behind the continuous beams with a fixed support. Now we will move on to our problem. So the problem is a continuous beam ABC of uniform section with a span AB as 8 meter and BC as 6 meter is fixed at A and simply supported at B and C. The beam is carrying a UDL of 1 kilonewton per meter throughout its length. Find the moment along the beam and reactions it supports. Also draw the bending moment and shear force diagram. So first of all, we will draw the diagram, the given diagram. Okay, so the continuous beam is ABC. That means it is a two span beam, right? It is a two-span beam, two-span ABC. It is fixed at A and simply supported at B and C. So, fixed at A, simply supported at B and C. The beam is carrying a UDL of 1 kilonewton per meter throughout its length. So, everywhere along the span AB and along the span BC, the load is 1 kilonewton per meter. So, in the span BC also, it is 1 kilonewton per meter. Find the moment along the beam and reaction at the support. Okay, also the span AB is given as 8 meter and the span BC is given as 6 meter. So, the span length of AB is 8 meter and the span length of BC is 6 meter. Now, how will we solve this problem? See, as usual, our first step is, hope you remember the first step. So, our first step is to draw the symbol beam moment diagram. And because this is a fixed support at A, because one extreme support is A, we have to assume an imaginary span to the left of A. Okay, so before going into our problem, we will draw the zero span also. So, this is A, we have B and C, we have a 1 kilonewton per meter loadings, 1 kilonewton per meter, and the span lengths are 8 meter and 6 meter. Now, we will draw an imaginary span to the left of A. Okay, so drawing an imaginary span to the left of A, we will take this support as A dash. It is an imaginary support, so any support you can take, fixed or simply supported. This is an imaginary support. Okay, now we will draw the symbol bending moment diagram, symbol beam moment diagram. So, we know how to draw the symbol beam moment diagram by assuming the supports as simply supported. So, that is our step 1, okay. Sorry. Okay. We will move on to step 1. So, our step 1 is symbol beam moment diagram. Symbol beam moment diagram, this is nothing but our mu diagram. So, this is drawn by considering all these supports as symbol supports. So, here, see first, this is A dash A is an imaginary span, right? So, this is an imaginary span. There is no loading on it. So, we have two spans now, AB and BC. So, we will draw the span AB. So, AB. Since it is a symbol beam moment diagram, both the supports. Our assumption is all the supports are symbol supports. So, the loading condition is 1 kilonewton per meter. Span is 8 meter. This is A and B. Now, how will we draw the mu diagram? We know since this is a uniformly distributed load, the bending moment diagram will be a parabola. And the maximum bending moment will lie at the center, that is at a distance of 4 meter. Will lie at the center of the span, and this value will be equal to, that is M max will be equal to W L square by 8. So, that is equal to 1 into 8 square by 8, we get as 8 kilonewton. So, this is 8 kilonewton. Similarly, the second span is BC. So we will draw BC. We will assume the support B and C are symbol supports. And the loading condition is 1 kilonewton per meter. The span length is 6 meter. So here also, since the loading condition is UDL, we have our bending moment becomes a parabola. And the maximum value will be at the mid span, that is at a distance of 3 meter. So here the value of M max will be equal to W L square by 8. So W is 1, L square is 6. So 6 square by 8. So we get this as 4.5 kilonewton. So this value will be 4.5 kilonewton. Now we will draw this diagram here. Okay, our symbol beam moment diagram. So this is our given continuous beam. Now our symbol beam moment diagram will be, this is A, B and C. So here we have a parabola, and from BC also we have a parabola. Okay, sorry, this parabola, but the here it is 4.5. So we will draw this 4.5 just below this 8 kilonewton. This is not 8 kilonewton, 8 kilonewton meter. 4.5 kilonewton meter. This is moment. So we will draw this below this. Okay. So this is 8 kilonewton meter. And here it is 4.5 kilonewton meter. Now we will find, now our aim is, our step 2 is, we have to find the area and the distance. Area multiplied by the distance. What is area into x bar of this symbol beam moment diagram? So we will write here, this is our symbol beam moment diagram. Okay. Now, so here, listen now. See here, we have to consider, our unknowns are at A, moment at A, and moment at B. We have two unknowns. Therefore, we will be taking the theorem of three moments, Clapeyron's theorem, we will consider the span A dash A, A B. We will consider this set of span and A B B C. Now listen, this A B comes twice, right? For the first set, A B is on the right side. For the second set, AB is on the left side. Now, therefore, our distance x bar will be calculated from the extreme ends. That means, while considering the span A dash A, AB, we have to calculate this x bar from B. When we are considering the spans AB, BC, we have to take x bar from A. So this is A, this is B, C, sorry, this is B and C. Now, so how will we calculate A into x bar? This is a parabola. So, we are calculating A into x bar is equal to, our area is, area of the parabola, 2 by 3 into base. Here the base is taken as 8. Base is 8, total distance is 8. So, half into base into height. So the height is 8 into, now we will calculate x bar. This is area, right? This is area. Area is over. So area multiplied by x bar. X bar is the distance taken from D. It is 4. So we get 170.67. Now, see both the sides. When you take the extreme end as A or B, since it is a parabola and since it is an UDL, the x bar, that is the center of gravity, lies at the middle of the span. So it is 4 from both the sides. So it is not necessary to calculate this x bar once again. Here, now for this span BC, our area into x bar will be equal to 2 by 3 into base is 6, height is 4.5 multiplied by x bar is 3. So we get 54. Now we will apply the theorem of 3 moments. Okay. So we will apply the theorem of 3 moments, that is our step 3. So step 3, we have to determine what are the unknowns. So in this span, the unknowns are moment at A, moment at B, moment at B. Moment at C, C is simple support, so moment at C will be equal to 0. A is fixed support, so moment at A is not equal to 0. B is an intermediate support, so moment at B is not equal to 0. So our unknowns are moment at A and moment at B. So unknown moments. Step 3 is the determination of unknown moments. Therefore, the unknown moments are moment at A and moment at B. And moment at C will be equal to 0. Now, the step 4, we will apply the theorem of 3 moments. So, step 4, apply theorem of 3 moments. So, we know the theorem of 3 moments is, so when we are applying the theorem of 3 moments, we have to consider the pair of spans. So, first pair of spans. So, two equations we need. Therefore, two pair of spans is required. So, first pair of span is A dash A and AB. A dash A and AB. Okay. So, we are considering A dash A and AB. So, first set of span. We are considering the spans A dash A, AB. Okay, so when we consider this set of spans, we will write the equation of 3 moments. So the equation of 3 moments is MA into L1 by I1 plus 2 times MB into L1 by I1 plus L2 by I2. Plus sorry see here it is A B and this is A dash, right? So here becomes M A dash. Intermediate support is A here. A, it is not B, here it is A. And the third support is B. So we have MB into L2 by I2 is equal to minus 6 into A1 X1 bar by I1 L1 plus A2 X2 bar by I2 L2 plus 6 into E delta, that is the left, is A dash. A dash by L1 plus E delta, the right support, B by L2. Now, this is a zero span. AB, the distance is 8 meter. Okay. So, we know A dash is an imaginary span. So, this value becomes 0. So, we get 2 times MA into this L1 is an imaginary span. So, L1 becomes 0. We get 2 times MA into L2 by I2 plus moment at B. It is an intermediate support. So, moment is not equal to 0. MB into L2 by I2 is equal to minus 6 into, see, the first is an imaginary span. There is no load on the span. So, there is no bending moment due to the load. So, here this term becomes 0. This term becomes 0. So, the next term A2 X2 bar by I2 L2. This, there is no settlement. So, this term becomes 0. So, that's all. Now, 2 times MA is unknown. See, this I2 is same. So, we can cancel I2. The value for L2 is 8 meter into 8 plus MB into L2 is 8 meter. This is L1. L1 is 0. L2 is 8 meter. Is equal to minus 6 A2 X2. So, A2 X2 is, see, for this diagram, A dash A B. For A dash A B, the symbol B moment diagram is this. Here we have a zero span. So, for this span, A dash A, it is A1 X1. And for AB, this is A2, X2. So, what is the AX for the span AB? We have already calculated for the span AB, AX bar is 170.67. So, minus 6 into 170.67 divided by L2. So, L2, the distance is 8. So, what we get is 16 MA plus 8 MB is equal to minus 128.0025. This is our equation 1. So, first span is over. Now, we will consider the second span. So, next span, second span is span ABBC. You can see here the second set of span is span ABBC, ABBC. So, now we will consider the span ABBC. Okay. So, we will consider the span ABBC. So, while considering the span ABBC, A is fixed support, B is intermediate support, and C is symbol supports. So, the span length is 8 meter and 6 meter. For BC, it is 6 meter. We have this symbol B moment diagram also. Now, we will apply the theorem of three moments. So, we will consider this. So, the theorem of three moments here is m a into L1 by I1. So I is same. So we will write this as I. There is no variation in I is not given. Plus 2 times intermediate support, that is MB, moment of the intermediate support, MB into L1 by I1 plus L2 by I2 plus MC, third moment, MC into L2 by I2 is equal to minus 6 into A1 X1 bar by I L1 or I1 L1 plus A2 X2 bar by I2 L2 plus 6 into E delta A by L1 plus E delta C by L2. Now this term becomes 0 because there is no settlement of support. Here MA is not equal to 0. So MA into, we will cancel all the I. L1 is 8. MA into 8 plus 2 times MB is not equal to 0. I gets cancelled everywhere. L1 is 8 plus L2 is 6 plus MC. See, C is the extreme support, symbol support. So, moment at C is equal to 0. So, this term becomes 0 is equal to minus 6 into A1 X1 bar and A2 X2 bar. That is, the area into distance of the span AB, A2 X2 bar is area into distance of the span BC. Okay. So, for AB, the span AB, the area is 170.67 and for BC the area is 54. So 170.67 divided by L1 is 8 plus 54 divided by L2 is 6. So we get 8 MA plus 28 MB is equal to minus 182.0025. This is equation number 2. Now we have equation number 1 and equation number 2. So solving 1 and 2. Solving 1 and 2 we get MA is equal to minus 5.54 kilonewton meter. And MB is equal to minus 4.92 kilonewton meter. So both values are negative values. That means at the A and B we have Hawking bending moment, negative bending moments. Now we will draw these bending moments. Okay. So bending moment. So, this is a simple beam moment diagram. Now, we will draw bending moment due to fixing support. So, due to fixing support, okay. So, A, MA is minus 5.54. So, it comes here. Minus 5.54 kilonewton meter and MB is minus 4 point. So it is below this 4.92 kilonewton meter and see it is a simple support, it is a zero. So this is our bending moment due to fixing support. So we will write bending moment due to fixing support. Now the bending moment of the given diagram will be given beam, given continuous beam will be a combination of these both, right? Bending moment due to simple beam moment diagram and bending moment due to fixing support. So combining these both, we will draw our bending moment diagram now. So our bending moment diagram will be bending moment diagram for the given simply supported beam will be, so from A to B we have a parabola, from B to C we have a parabola, and the magnitude is 8 and 4.5. So this is 8 kilonewton meter and this is 4.5 kilonewton meter. And now this fixing support, bending moment due to fixing support is 5.54. So here it is 5.54 and here it is 4.92, so slightly greater than this. So 4.92 kilonewton meter, here also it is kilonewton meter. So we join this and join this. Here it is zero. So at this point, see, at this point we have negative bending moment. Here we have positive bending moment. This is positive. Here once again we have a negative bending moment. And here we have a positive bending moment. This is positive. This is positive. That means near the supports, near the fixed support and intermediate support, we will have a negative bending moment. That means a hogging bending moment, which means our deflection diagram will be, see here you will have a small hogging up to this point, up to this point. Then you will have a sagging up to this point, and from this to this you will have a hogging, and from this point you will have a sagging bending moment or deflection. Okay, so this is your bending moment diagram, this is your deflection diagram. Now our aim is to find the shear force diagram. So how will we draw the shear force diagram? Okay, so for that, once again we will draw the diagram. Okay, so this is A, B and C. We have 1 kilonewton per meter, another 1 kilonewton per meter. This is 8 meter and this is 6 meter. Now we know the moments, right? So the moment, that is we know what is the fixing moments. So fixing moments at A, it is negative, right? So we have a fixing moment of 5.54 here. Here we have the moments of 4.92 and at C it is 0. Now we will take the moments to the right of B. Now our unknowns are the vertical reactions at A, B and C. We have three unknowns: vertical reaction at A, vertical reaction at B and vertical reaction at C. So now we will take moments to the right of B. See, A is fixed support, B and C are simple supports. So it is better to take to the right of B and to the right of A. when we are taking the moment to the right to fail. So first case, taking moment to the right of B. What we get is, see, we are considering the section B. So this, we know the right anti-clockwise is positive. So RC is positive. RC into 6. Okay. So vertical reaction at C. RC into 6. This is the reaction at C. There is a reaction at B and a reaction at A. So RC into 6. Now this is negative. Minus 1 into 6 into the distance is 3. Half of the distance is 3. Now, this is, we are considering the right of the section, right? Right of B. So, right, this is anti-clockwise. Right anti-clockwise is positive. So, it is plus 4.92 is equal to 0. So, otherwise, you can take RC into 6 minus 1 into 6 into 3. Is equal to minus 4.92. So from this you get RC is equal to 2.18 kilonewton. So RC is 2.18 kilonewton. Now we will take the section to the right of A, taking moment to the right of A. Okay. So now taking the moment to the right of A, we get, so we'll consider RC into 6 plus 8, that is 14. Okay. So RC into 14 minus, see, we have 1 kilonewton throughout. So 1 into 8 plus 6 is 14. 1 into 14 into the central distance is 7, 14 by 2. So 1 into 14 into 7 minus 1 into 14 into 7. Now, see this, this is, here you have a clockwise and anti-clockwise, 4.92. So, when you take the section here, these both gets cancelled. So, plus and minus, plus 4.92 and minus 4.92, this get cancelled. So, this is not considered. If you are considering also, it will get cancelled. Okay. So, you can take plus 4.92 minus 4.92. I am not writing here because it get cancelled. Plus, so we are taking the right of the section. We know right anticlockwise is positive. When you take right of the section, right anticlockwise is positive. So, 5.54 will be positive. So, plus 5.54 is equal to 0, from which we get R. We left this RB. We have RB into 8. One more. Plus RB into 8 is equal to 0. So RC is already found. It is 2.18. Substituting, we get RB is equal to 7.74 kilonewton. So RB is 7.74 kilonewton. Now the only unknown left is RA. So, we know RA plus RB plus RC is equal to 1 into 14. Upward reactions is equal to downward loads. So, we get RA is equal to 4.08 kilonewton. RA is equal to 4.08 kilonewton. Now, we can draw the shear force diagram. So, how will we draw the shear force diagram? Okay, so now RA is 4.08 upwards. So it is 4.08 kilonewton. Now there is an UDL up to B, and here it is 7.74 kilonewton. So at B it is 1 into 8. So totally 8. So 4.08 minus 8, we get 3.92, minus 3.92. So here it is minus 3.92. So 3.92, and here there is a reaction 7.74. So 3.92 minus 7.74, we get 3.82. So here we get 3.82. Now, here the total load is 1 into 6. So 3.82 minus 6, we get 2.18. So here it is 2.18. This is 2.18. Now 2.18 minus 2.18, we get minus 2.18 plus 2.18, we get 0. Okay. So this is our shear force diagram. This is positive, negative, positive, and negative. So this is our shear force diagram. So hope you all understood. See, the important thing is how to draw this. I'll repeat once again. This is our given problem. Our given problem is ABC. A is fixed, B is single support, C is also single support. So since A is extreme support is fixed, we are assuming an imaginary span A dash A. So after this, we will first draw the simple beam moment diagram. Since it is UDL, we will take the condition WL square by 8. So we will draw this. After finding this, find what is calculate area into X bar. Then see what are the unknown moments. Now apply the theorem of three moments by taking the spans. So we need two equations. So we need three spans. So we are adding an imaginary span to the left of A. So A dash A, AB is our first set of span. AB, BC is our second set of span. We are applying the theorem of three moments. And we got, this is the bending moment due to fixing support. Now the combination of these both will be our bending moment diagram. So after this, we have drawn the deflection diagram. So after that, once again, we have considered the moment because we have to find the reactions RA, RB and RC using the conditions of equilibrium or static equilibrium. Now since this is fixed support, we are taking the right of B and right of A. That will be easy. Okay, we are taking the right of A and right of B. Otherwise, you can also take left of B also. You will get the same answer. So when you are taking the right of A and right of B, we get the value. When you take the right of B, we get RC, the reaction at C. And when you take right of A, you will get the reaction at B. So after finding the reactions at RA, RB and RC, we can draw the shear force diagram. Thank you. Thank you for listening.